One of the most frustrating problems for parents is bedwetting, or we call it nocturnal enuresis. You have a child that, toilet trained early, 2 or 3, just can't get dry at bed. It's traumatic, not only for the parents, but also for the child. They can't go to sleepovers, they're afraid to go to camp. It's hurts their, you know, development of their independence and their self-esteem. So parents are often eager for a cure. Typically, when I see kids with bedwetting, they come to our office and they've been tried on several medicines. They've been tried on some bladder relaxing medicines. Other pediatricians, they've been trying medicines to limit urine production at night. And the parents have tried every trick in the book. They try waking them up at, you know, 2 or 3 times a night. They try putting them in underwear so they'll feel the wetness and all that. Can assure you will fail. We found through research at Wake Forest Baptist Health that the bowels, believe it or not, you got to trust me on this one, are a main contributor to bedwetting. Most of the kids that wet the bed have constipation that's unknown to the child or the parent. What I mean by that is they don't poop hard stools, or they don't poop irregularly, they poop every day. But due to the way children go to the bathroom, they have a large burden of stool in the rectum, which is the end part of the colon. If you can clean that out, bedwetting will cease. Constipation can be treated with a combination of laxatives or enemas, but typically is best done under the guidance of a doctor. So a question parents often have is, how can my child be constipated, and if they're having poops, if they're pooping every day, or if their poops are soft? So what I think the big misunderstanding about this topic is a semantic one, is that it's a definition problem. If you're talking about constipation, you're thinking of people that have hard stools, or they stool rarely. When you're thinking about children with bedwetting, the problem is more of a fecal burden. Imagine an assembly line, okay? That's what the colon is, and it's moving along. And the stool moves from the beginning of the colon to the end, which is the rectum, and then you let it out. That's how adults go to the bathroom. Kids don't go to the bathroom that way, because when the stool gets to the end, they're playing on their Xbox, or they're outside, so they hold it in. And the colon is very compliant. It expands, so the stool builds up and fills the entire pelvis in some cases until they feel the need to go. This doesn't happen overnight. It happens over years, you know, of holding slightly every day. But as that builds up, it crowds out the bladder, number one, and also causes a nerve reaction that makes the bladder more hyperactive. So addressing that stool burden, which is sometimes hidden unless you do an x-ray and ultrasound, is key to treating most voiding problems, especially bedwetting.